Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, thank you. Can you all double your clapping for the one and only Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Because of Him, we are here. Because of Him, who we are. Because of Him, you know, we become a God kind. Hallelujah. Please be seated. Praise the Lord. Amen. How are you guys? Happy to see you again. I don't know what you feel about me, but I feel so thrilled to see you guys again.
Amen.
When I went and edited my videos, you know, I was overwhelmed by your clapping noise. Amen. Thank you. Thank you very much. And I really thank Jesus Christ. And I thank Pastor Anthony Sill and Pastor Amma and you guys. You guys are simply amazing. And I believe that God has, my calling has been manifested is through this church, Prime Ministries, and I really owe you. Nowadays, I have been known by, you know, the Christian clique in a good way or bad way, and somebody have recently put my name under the prosperity preachers. And they, you know, they attacked me, but I don't mind, because it's never ever in Bible says the prosperity preachers are bad, but the Bible is, you know, Jesus Christ Himself said the teachers of law are the bad fruit. Only the God He came to give us a life with abundance, and that abundance life including the prosperity. Prosperity means it's not just money and notes. Prosperity means health, wealth, happiness, joy, peace, your children, your generations, blessings is all under the prosperity. Hallelujah. Whoever met God in even the Old Testament, they never be a poor people. David was a, you know, shepherd with a number of, not small number of flocks of sheep, but at the end when he passed on to his crown, to his son Solomon, he was a mighty, mighty millionaire. He was given to his son the tons of gold. So it's not bad. Guy started with having few flocks of lamb, and he ended up with a mighty, mighty millionaire and a very successful king over Israel over 40 years. So whoever met God, truly met God, they always prosper. Hallelujah. So don't mind. And don't become a religious fellow that you suffering, keep yourself suffering, is pleasing God. No. Our Heavenly Father is a King of Kings, God of God. He is simply your daddy. Simply is your daddy. Amen. That is the truth. I mean, in Tamil, we have heard so many, preachings that says, they normally call Kartave, Kartave. Devari, Devari, it's like a distant, God. But simply you and me call Abba, Father. Or in our Tamil, Appa, and single is Tate, is right? And, Daddy, so you, because that's what is meant to be. That's why the Bible, when they say, I think Galatians or something, they say, they call the Holy Spirit, is calling, spiritually when you call God, you call Abba, Father. Hallelujah. So you are the rightful children of God. You are of God. That's what Bible says. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm really, really happy. And I once again thank Pastor Anderson and Pastor Amma. Shall we pray for the word of God? Our Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you for your everlasting presence. Thank you, Jesus. For your ministry, we become the children of God. We can call the Heavenly Father, Abba Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for your everlasting presence. The Christ in us, the hope of glory. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Father, you've taken care of this word of God, and you said in the Bible, do not worry, go there, and I will give you the word in your mouth or in your tongue. You will preach. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are doing your ministry in me. Especially I command my tongue to to be preaching only the word of grace and the word of life in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. God bless you guys. Since we have been covered in online, I want to go through quickly what is mean by born again Christian. And whoever want to be a born again Christian right now, whoever in online, please pray with me. It's simple. That's once you call Jesus Christ, call from your heart, is your Lord of your life, and believe in your heart that the Heavenly Father resurrected Jesus Christ on third day and He lives forever. That's all. That's all. And I'm going to preach what are the blessings you are entitled or you are inherited when you are being born again. So whoever listen to me on online, please pray with me, and you also as a church you pray with me. Say, Jesus, you are my Lord of my life. I believe the Heavenly Father resurrected you on third day, and you are, say, open your mouth and say, unless you say you are my Lord, nothing will happen. Because devil also believe in the heart that God is a mighty God, but he never born again, because he never say that Jesus Christ is the Lord of his life. But we call Jesus Christ. Can you say, Jesus Christ is Lord of my life? Amen. Spiritually, there's a miracle happened to you now, right now. You are becoming child of God. You are a born again Christian. Hallelujah. Amen. Why don't you give a big hand of applause for those who are being saved on online, and let them come to know what God has prepared for them eternally. Because Christianity is not a religion, as I said. This is, you become a child of God. You become an actually extending arms of Christ on earth. You are walking as a representing or manifesting the Christ in you to the world. In other words, you are a carrying vessel or the temple of a living God. Hallelujah. If anybody want to have a contact with God, they will come and touch with you. Hallelujah. This is the true reality. I mean, many religion or even so-called Christian religion, they will not accept that. They believe the God is somewhere. They are here to try to please Him, and one day, maybe one day, they may receive salvation or they may go to heaven. But we know by the word of God, and we know that clearly it's not the case. You are becoming child of God like that, spiritually. Hallelujah. Amen. Okay, first we read John chapter 1. But I'll tell you the story today. Today I thought, I came from Mincham and Croydon, and it was heavy snowing. Then my flesh said, so look, it's very cold. You may get stuck in the traffic. And I look at through the windows, it's snowing. I love snow because it looks so beautiful. Then I don't want to take my authority and cancel the snow. So I enjoyed that bit. Then I thought, okay, today I'll call Pastor Amma and say, it's a bit difficult. I was struggling from the 4 o'clock in the morning. I was thinking. And at 12 o'clock, said, okay, call it off. So I called and said, look, it's bad weather, traffic reports are bad and things like that. But my heart wasn't resting. And I was reading, I was, opening the Bible, it's nothing, I'm telling the truth. Then our beloved pastor called me from Canada. He said, we have to shake this world. We declare that we are the men of faith. If you stop anything, it should stop, man. I am in Canada, it's minus 40 or something, but there's no snow. Because I am here, I told, no, while I'm here, there's no traffic disruption, no snow. So look at outside, why don't you exercise your thing? I said, it was like 1 o'clock or something. I said, that's it, I can't stay with this. guilty feeling anymore. I jump out from the, I had my good breakfast, so under the quilt, I throw it out. I said, give me 10 minutes, you call Pastor Amma. I said, I'll be coming. So, but thank God, there's no traffic. And I took the longest route, show me 42 months, but I came within one hour or things like that. So man, you are in charge of this world. You are the manager of this world. There's no even any kind of weather, any kind of situation cannot stop you. I normally come, take me 2 hours when I come in normally. But today I came in 1 hour and 11 minutes exactly. And come on, we can do anything. That's what Paul said. I can do all things through Jesus Christ. Okay? So I said sorry to God and he's accepted. John chapter 1 verses 12. I'm talking about the born again Christian. Especially I'm preaching on online. Just put the foundation, because many people doesn't know what is born again Christian means. 12. John, Gospel of John chapter 1 verses 12. But as many as received him, to them gave he the right to become children of God. God has given us a right to become children of God, even to them that believe on his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of the man, but of God. So say Amen. Say you are of God. You are of God means, tiger produce tiger cub, dog produce puppies, I don't know. But God produced God kind. Why don't you give a big hand to that? Whoever born again today, according to Bible, you are of God, means you are born out of God.
Amen.
So you have a God kind, and God nature is already deposited in your new spirit, new birth. Say Amen.
Amen.
Man is a spirit being. Spirit being means, come on. Say I'm talking to you, okay? This is a voice is coming through the amplifier. You are receiving my voice. But your ear just collecting all the noises. Hallelujah. And then your mind is analyzing. Now this is a Mahan brother voice. And he's speaking in English. And you understand what I meant by receiving my voice call. This is a spiritual thing. If you open your brain, what is there? Blood, water, some cells, blood cells, that's all. How is it working out? It's a massive operation. Some people you could see, they have a perfect eardrum, and nothing wrong with them, but they cannot hear. Hallelujah. But the man is a spirit being. Everything is a spirit being. But the unfortunate things, man started to restrict himself through the 5 senses only. The touch, even touching our fingers, you can touch and you understand what is it. You look at this, what is this? It's like some skin, and if you cut it open, and some cells. But if you train yourself, you will find out. So man is a spirit being. Don't be, spirit being thinks something else. Spirit means something beyond your 5 senses. That is spirit. Spiritual word means which you cannot understand through your 5 senses. So man is a spirit being. According to Bible, Jesus said, I think John 6:63, the word of God I speak is life and spirit. Spirit and life. So you are a spirit being, so you can understand what a spirit means. According to spirit, the word of God clearly saying to you, you are, even before you were called Jesus Christ your Lord, before you are born out of your natural physical parents. But spiritually, it's a miraculous thing that all of a sudden your DNA setup is altered. You become a child of God. Child of God. According to God, according to the mighty God. You are His kind. Hallelujah. You are have His nature. Say amen. Bible says, when you're born again, you are becoming the body of Christ. Jesus Christ is your head, and you are the body of Christ. You are the temple of the living God. How come? Bible says He's the head, and you are His body. Church is body. How come head and body can be connected? It is not being the same kind. For example, if you need a kidney transplant, they normally look for the own siblings from the same family, same blood group, same type of the cell structure. Then and only the kidney or whatever transplant will accept the body. So you have been spiritually transplanted by your head is becoming Jesus Christ. Why don't you give a big hand to God? Unless you become in the same kind, it cannot be connected. Hallelujah. Amen. This, you understand all, you know that. If you have a, unless you cannot connect, pig into a lion, because they're two different type of species. But now you become the same species like God. Same time, same likeness of God. Don't ever put yourself down. Hallelujah. Even the weather is against you, you can't stop it. Because you are. Bible says, I read again, look, 11. He came into 12. John chapter 1 verses 12. But as many as received Him, to them gave He the right. He has given you the right to become children of God. Even to them that believe in His name, who are born not of a blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of a man, but of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So you should know now, you are born of God.
Amen.
Say, I am 100% agree with the word of God, which is clearly talking to me. It's clearly telling to me that I am being a born again Christian. I am of God. I am from God. Heavenly Father is my legal daddy. Hallelujah. 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 All your problems are over, man. We break our head for nothing. You don't. Many of us here have children, and I have three. Even they grow, tall and bigger. I have the parental urging inside me. They come late, my mind go wide, then I praise. No problem, they'll come home. Thank God for them. But otherwise, I have an anxiety, where is he gone, or where is she gone, what she's doing, and things like that. I have the parental thinking about him. Same way, the Heavenly Father has a parental urge towards you. I don't want to give you a big hand. He is your daddy. Close your eyes and believe. Daddy, I believe you. You are a mighty God. You are a mighty God. I'm God kind. Religion will never accept that. All the religions put together, they will never bring you to the same class with God. But Christianity is not a religious thing. Christianity is a true living God come and take over your body. Hallelujah. That's why Jesus said, spirit, man is a spirit. Bible says, look again, he's a born out of spirit. Hallelujah. Jesus said when he's talking about spirit, in John chapter 3, he said, look, why don't we read John chapter 3? He compared spirit to the wind, okay? Sister, the wind bloweth, okay, that which is born of flesh is flesh, but that which is born of spirit is spirit. I'm telling you, you are born out of spirit, because the word of God, he said, is a spirit. When you believe the word of God, when you say Jesus Christ your Lord, say spiritual Lord, you become a child of, legal child of God. Hallelujah. That 8, okay, see, Jesus Christ immediately comparing the spirit into wind. Okay? The wind blows wherever it pleases. You hear its sound, but you cannot tell where it comes from, where it's going. So it is everyone born of spirit. Same way, he's comparing spirit to a wind. For example, if you check your body, all your cells have an oxygen circulation. Hallelujah. If the air or oxygen is not circulated in your body, it will die out. So your body is filled with the oxygen. How is the air is filled your body? Same way the spirit, when you born again, is filled in you.
Amen.
Why don't you give a big hand to that Lord? You cannot understand your five senses, but you are believing Jesus is our Lord and our God. Whatever He says, so I believe it. So you know now you have been filled with the spirit. Amen.
Amen.
God kind of spirit, God kind of life is inside you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Quickly, I will say 1 John chapter 5. I quote this one, but never mind. 5:11. And this is the testimony. So God is telling you, God has given us eternal life. He's going to give you eternal life when you die and go to heaven? No. Right now, God has, look at the tense. God has given us eternal life. Why don't you give a big hand to that brother? This is talking about what kind of life you are made out of. So any cold, any sickness cannot destroy you. This is the truth, absolute truth. Amen. It only works when you believe it, man. First you should know, I am filled with an eternal life. If you have any symptom, talk to the symptom. Say, I am filled with an eternal life. You have no business in being out. That is the way you reign. Hallelujah. Okay. This life is in His Son. Whoever has Son has life. We have Son because I have a life. Whoever does not have Son of God does not have life. I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have an eternal life. Why they are written in the Bible? You should know. Say, I know now.
I know now.
I have an eternal life in my soul, in my spirit, and my body. That's it. Say, I believe it. Say, I mean it. Say, when I say it, I mean it. So you are telling your situation, look, I'm not an ordinary mankind. I'm a God kind.
Amen.
My God, my man type of life is been replaced with an eternal life, which is a God kind of life.
Amen.
You declare yourself, look, you are no longer the same person. You are a different person. That's what the Bible says. If a man in a Christ is a new creation, means he has no past. He's a completely new creation and he's born with eternal life.
Amen.
You can expect all the time victorious.
Hallelujah.
A man can have a day to day up and down, but God will never. God is not a defeated fellow. Come on, agree with me? God is not a sad story. God's life is not a sad story. It's a success. You are born out of the same success. But you need to tune your mind. Who am I in Christ? What has happened to me? I look at the word and you believe it. I'm telling you, I'm keep telling this. Last 11 and a half years, I never taken a single Panadol. I'm over 50. I don't have a cough. I don't have a cold, thadiment, or even a flu, or even no time at all. Because I believe like a child. My life, my body is filled with an eternal life. Eternal life. Eternal life. Listen, mind, you listen to me. You have an eternal life. So this sickness cannot overtake you. Will cannot destroy you. Just believe it. Your work, your life, your family cannot be destroyed. I'm telling you, man. Success after success. Because I believe you, I have an eternal life. Hallelujah. Be happy, man. Lord, admit this. Then you go and do your things, you will be successful. Not only success for yourself, you will be success to your community, your family, your thing. So you know that you have an eternal life, and You are a God kind. That's why you are one big God. Hallelujah. And second point is, you are the righteous of God. Shall we read 2 Corinthians 5:21? Those who are listening on online, I'm telling you, you are the righteous of God in Christ Jesus.
Amen.
Why don't we say this? I am righteous of God in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. I told you in the past, there was a testimony. There was a guy, you know, he's a kind of alcoholic. He came into my Bible studies, and in drunkenness, he said, I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Immediately, he was delivered. Hallelujah. Tell you a story. I told you about one guy, it's a Pakistani guy, who came to contact me, I think, in this, I think July or August. I went to pray for him in his hospital. And a friend of mine who called me, so I went to a hospital in kind of out of London. And he was had a cancer, and I think his testicle has a cancer, and he was scratching his body on the bed. And when we went there, he was having his, finishing his fasting, the Muslim, Ramadan, something out there, finishing his fasting. While he was doing his religious activities, I told him, look, Jesus here to heal you. Okay? Be bold when he says this. Don't think you are, you know, being very pride. This is according to the word of God. I am carrying his eternal life. Who am I then? Come on. I am his kind. Okay? And he is living in me. So I'm not going to the hospital because I done PhD on cancerous, how to heal the cancerous. I'm going to hospital because I believe the healer, the Jesus Christ, is dwelling in me.
Amen.
When I lay hands, he is laying hands. Okay? That is my bold belief. Okay, I went there, then I said, Jesus is here, do you want to accept him as your Lord? And he wanted to heal. He said, yes. Then I prayed for him. They have given him a 1 week to live. I prayed for him, and that's it. I mean, on our eyes, nothing happened. That's a spiritual thing. It's not meant for your eyes and your senses. You do what the word of God says, that's it. It will happen. So I came back, and after a few days, they set him free. I mean, not set him free, sent him home. And he was okay, he was eating, and he was not completely healed, but he was okay. He was staying in on top of the shop. This, my friend is running the shop. So time to time I would call him and pray, and my friend also prayed. 2 weeks back, or one and a half weeks back, early in the morning, that friend called me. He said his case is very serious. He's not eating nowadays, so he's so become so weak. So we called an ambulance and his relatives. So all the Pakistani friends all came. I think he said 7 or 8 of them came. Like almost sent him off. You know, that's it, goodbye. So in the midst of that my friend had a faith in Jesus and also in me. He said, Muhammad, please, I'll put in a speaker, can you go and pray in the midst of their meetings? So I said, okay. I closed the eyes because I don't want to think too much. So I closed my eyes. I said, in the name of Jesus, I come against every cancerous spirit. I curse you to death. I command you out of his body. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I command a life right now. That's it. Then the ambulance came. He went. Fine. After a couple of days, 3 days, early in the morning, he called me around 8 o'clock. He said, do you know the news? I said, tell me quickly, what is it? I can't hold it anymore. He said, doctor said, this person has no cancerous at all. And he's not that fluent in English, that guy. He said, the brother from London, and Jesus, he prayed. That's all he said. Brother from London and Jesus prayed. Then I called him to his ward, and he said, I am healed. Doctor said there is no traces of cancer. I am fine. And he came home. You and me have said, there's no difference between you and me. My daddy is your daddy. The daddy of Jesus Christ is your daddy. This is the truth, man. This is the absolute truth. Hallelujah. Start believing and doing it. Hallelujah. When cases come like that, I meditate this. I believe. And I say to myself, look, don't think in medical terms. Think in spiritual terms. Find out who you are and go and act upon. Hallelujah. Okay. So you know you have an eternal life. The second point is, you are the righteousness of God. Righteousness means you are okay with God. You can go anytime in front of Him. Without fear, without inferiority complex, without any uncleanness or unworthiness, you can face God face to face. Lord, Father, I'm here in the name of Jesus. He will never look into what's wrong you made, what you haven't done, what you have done. Because the righteousness is a free gift. When the minute you believe Jesus Christ, you can talk to your daddy without any hindrance directly. Hallelujah. Why don't you give a big hand for them? So 2 Corinthians 5:21. How is it possible? God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. God made who? Jesus Christ. Who had no sin. Jesus Christ, the pure of pure sin, to be sin. Hallelujah. Because he became a sin for us. For you and me. So if anybody pointing up to you about your sinness, say, tell them shut up. Because Heavenly Father given Jesus Christ for my sin has been sorted. Hallelujah. The major ministry of Jesus Christ, he come to sort out our sin issue. Say amen.
Amen.
Has he done it or has he done it?
Yes,
he has done it, man. So no more sin conscious to you at all.
Hallelujah.
The many Christian churches are suffering with the sin conscious. Today, Sunday, they have been blastering all over the world, especially India, Sri Lanka. You are a sinner. How come you come closer to God? Sin was not my choice. I was born out of sin. Now I am born out of God. Hallelujah. So the sin is sorted once and for all. Bible says, God had made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become righteousness of God. Means he's been justified according to righteousness of God. But in another translation, you have been justified. Justified means what? You are not guilty. You are innocent. How come? I knew my sins. I knew what I have done. But the word of God says, no. There's no guilty. There's no traces of sin at all. And you are, righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. How come it's possible? I don't want to drag on. Because it is possible. When you born again, the guy who was sinful person was buried. When you born again, when you resurrected with Jesus Christ, you are a completely new person. Hallelujah. Because according to God, you don't have any past. So if you have anything bothering you in your heart or anything you done, when I was young, but don't carry that guilty feelings anymore. Because that person who done all the nastiest things, it was buried. He was cleansed by the blood of Jesus and he was buried. But when Jesus Christ resurrected, I became a new creature altogether. New creature means ever existed before. Why don't you give a big answer? There's a couple of last Friday, I might have shared this testimony. There was a guy who came and he done a really nasty, I could say, crime. But when he came, he wanted to come inside because he couldn't comprehend his consciousness, what he has done. And there was a police case, and the police said, definitely, no, you are going inside. But this guy was thinking whether I let me end my life or not. So he called me, then I prayed with him, I asked him to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord, like the prayer I done it, he became a born again. Immediately he said, I wanted to meet you because my all the heavy hardness, my guilty feelings just left me like nothing. So I wanted to come and meet you. I said, come to the Bible studies of a Friday evening. So he came. And I told him what you mean by newborn again Christians. Means your past is no longer relevant at all. Because you, according to God, you don't have any past. You are a born again, new Christians. You are a God kind of person right now.
Amen.
He said, first time in my life, I come to know I'm not a sinner anymore. And a couple of days back, he called me, and the police said to him, look, definitely you are going inside. Well, you know, why are you looking? So you look happy. He said, in the name of Jesus, I cancel all the court cases. And he said, the greater one is dwelling in me than the one is in the world. Look at the mentality immediately. Police said, oh, sir, if it's your faith, that's it, go ahead. This is the love of our Heavenly Father. It's not because of he's the one is bad sinner. We all equally very bad. God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. This is the greatest thing in Christianity. All other religion, all your sin, you have to pay for it. Either money or by your anything, you should pay for it. But thank God, we have a Savior, we have a mediator, we have an atonement. His name is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He took my place and he has given his place into my spirit. That is the true nature of me. How I don't give a big answer of applause. You should carry no longer any guilty feeling about anything, man. The guilty feeling is a real killer. Maybe the doctor said, if people, attacked by cancer, when they have analyzed the many percentage was having a guilty feelings, that is a deep-rooted cause for all the sickness. So from now on, you have no guilty feeling at all. Because he was being paid fully for all your sins. When you're born again, you are born out of God.
Amen.
What made Jesus Christ to be Jesus Christ? The same life is being given to you. The same righteousness is being given to you. Hallelujah. So there are two characters we should know when you're born again. You are born out of God. Second, you are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. If you read in Bible, go and read it yourself. When you have a righteousness of God, he's the most blessed person. Bible says, the blessing of the Lord will rest upon the righteous of God.
Amen.
So every blessing will rest upon you. Actually, you are blessed more than that. I'll come back to you. And you are justified. Justified means, as I said, you have no guilty at all. It means you never ever commit any sin at all, any mistake at all. Can you believe it? Many Christians are preaching, your past sin, your past mistakes will follow you now. No way. Your past is that person has been buried. You are a new creature, completely a new person according to God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So you are justified. God found you not guilty.
Amen.
So God is telling you, whoever born again right now, whatever mistakes you made in the past, God is telling you, according to the word, you are not guilty at all. I don't give a big answer. Those who are listening and receiving this word of God, I'm telling you have been set free in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Don't worry about anything at all. You are a new creation. All your past sins been wiped out. You are a born of God right now. Okay? If you read Romans 5:1, therefore, since we have been justified through faith, what we are operating through faith. Is anybody seen Jesus Christ? Anybody seen blood of Jesus? Anybody seen the atonement of Jesus Christ? No, but we believe. Say, I believe. Things you believe, things you don't see. We believe, that's called faith. So, therefore, since we have been justified through faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Why don't you give a big hand of applause? Now, what's the status between you and God? It's peace. You have a peace with God.
Hallelujah.
Means He has no issues between you and him. To him, as Jesus is, so you are in this world. When you pray, as if Jesus is praying. When you pray for somebody, as if Jesus is praying for somebody. Because you are peace with Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. I'm telling you a good news, man. Why it's become like that? Because you accepted Jesus is your Lord through your faith. Immediately, you have a peace. You can be a worst kind of killer. But the minute you accept that Jesus is your Lord, immediately you have peace. Means no issue between you and Heavenly Father. If any blessings is not come through, it's not because of God. Father has a peace with you. Hallelujah. So you are everything clear. It's like you are receiving the letter from President. Look, I have sanction. Every blessing you wanted, I have given to you. You and me have a peace. Hallelujah. The good King of Kings, Heavenly Father, is telling you through the word of God, my dear children, you and me have no issues at all. We have peace. Why don't you give a big answer? There are so many people in this world. They are running around to the temple after temple, mosque after mosque, synagogue after synagogue, all over the world. They are trying to reach God. God, are you okay with me? Will you accept me? What do you think about me? Word of God clearly says, since you accepted Jesus is your Lord, God is telling you, my son, you and me have no issues at all. I have peace with you.
Hallelujah.
I have peace with you. I have peace with you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. 2 Corinthians 5:19. Are you happy, man? This is the reality. I'm reading after, because you should meditate this again and again. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against him. Can you imagine? World sin. God is not counting world sin. I'm telling you, whoever watching this, I'm telling you, it's a good news. God is not counting world sin at all. If any tsunami comes, if any natural disaster is not from God. Because God is not counting people's sin at all. Look again. The God was reconciling the word himself to Christ, not counting people's sins against him. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. What is the true message of Christianity, gospel? Go and tell everyone. Even the guys, the kind of worst kind of sinner, he can be in prison. Go and tell him, look, good news. God is not counting your sin anymore. He won to come to the kingdom of his beloved son by accepting him as your Lord.
Amen.
You can, this is the gospel, this is the evangelism. Go to tell anyone and everyone. That is a good, the people are thinking, I made this horrible mistake. I done this mistake. I don't think my God will accept me. Even the churches are preaching, will God will punish you. But this is the message. Look at this. The God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against him. And he has committed to us. Yeah, this is a message. One message, a message of grace, is that God has blessed you regardless of who you are. God has brought you in the oneness with Christ regardless of who you are, what you have done. That is called grace. Hallelujah. Why don't you give a big answer? This is the message God has given to us to preach all over the world. If you are preaching condemnation, if you are preaching the teachers of law, you are not preaching the word of God. You are preaching something else. Okay? So, not counting of people's sin against them, and he has committed us to the message of reconciliations. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God we are making his appeal to us. We implore you in Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. This is the message God said, be reconciled. God is ready. Whatever mistake you've done, he has, Jesus Christ has already paid. Come and reconcile. Hallelujah. Very simple, man. Okay. And you are sanctified. You are sanctified. How? 1 Corinthians 6:11. Since you are born again, these all are inbuilt in your life. This is what you are. Not you are going to be. Because it's like a human child when he's born. Maybe it's like a tiny bit. But all the 1-year-old child and a 25-year-old young man both have the same kind of humanism. Or how do you say? The human things is there. This baby look maybe may not look like a human, but all the human things is all already deposited in that baby. After 25 years, he will become a full grown up man. He walk in a two leg. When a baby, it will grow. But you couldn't say this is not a human because it's crawling in a four, legs and feet. It's a matter of time. It will stand up. Because the human thing is already deposited in that baby. Same way, the life of Jesus Christ is inside you. It's a matter of time. When you meditate, when you eat this word of God, matter of time, you will project Jesus on this earth. In your family, in your friends, in your community, you will project Jesus wherever you go. That's what Christians, how is the Christian name came? In a city of Antioch, people started to manifest Jesus Christ through them. So they said, look, as Jesus did, they are doing the same thing. So they call them Jesus Christians. Because they are doing what Christ done, they were doing it. You and me have a potentially, essentially having a Christ nature in you. It's a matter of time. You meditate this word of God. Eat this word of God. Same thing. That's what Jesus said. You will do greater miracles than I did. Because you have my same nature. I am going to Heavenly Father. I am only 33 years old. But you are going to live, say, 85 or 95. You will have more time than me. So you do more works. And you have my nature inside you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. This is called Christianity. That's all. 1 Corinthians 6:11. What happened to you? I will read from verses 10. No thieves or nor the greedy or drunkards nor slanderers or swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And that is what some of you were, thank God. God is never calling you are a swindler, a cheat, or fraud. He said you were, past tense, some of you were. But if you have a pen, if you can write a writable Bible, write it down. But big crowd, because you were washed. You'll be washed, or you were washed. You were sanctified and you were justified in the name of Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. Why don't you give a big answer? This is a heavenly report, is reading out to you. Say, look. You were washed. You were sanctified. You were justified in the name of Lord Jesus Christ and the Spirit of our God. Never ever call yourself, I'm a dirty. I'm a sinner. I'm a failure. I'm not worthy. That's a lie directly from devil. You are copying and you are pasting to the word. Stop that. Agree with the word of God. You are a son of God or a daughter of God. You are washed. Say, I was washed. Say yourself, I was washed. And I was sanctified. And I was justified. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. And by the Spirit of our God. Once and for all. Once and you are clean, man. You to God you are spotless. For God you are spotless because of the word of God clearly saying you have been washed, you have been sanctified, you have been justified in the name of Lord Jesus Christ and the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. So mark this one. If anybody attack you, or normally devil will attack you, no. How can you receive this blessing? Because you are not clean enough. Tell me, shut your mouth. Come and I'll read out the word of God for you. I was washed, I was sanctified, and I'm justified in the Lord, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, and by the Spirit of our God. Hallelujah. This is the greatest report. It's like, you know, you are perfect. You are perfect. Whatever God is giving you a report, you are perfect. You are sanctified and you are justified. Means take out any guilty feelings. Even you can be the worst kind of murderer or adulterer, since you are born again, this is the reality. This is the report from God is telling you. You were washed, you were sanctified, you are justified. Justified means not guilty, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, by the Spirit of our God. What a good news, man. You are perfect. Kind of, do you believe this is what happened to you? This is what happened to you. Just believe it, okay? You have no other choice because the Word of God. You can analyze this. This is what happened. And you are delivered. Those who are born again have been delivered. The Christian doesn't mean deliverance. He is the deliverer actually. He go and deliver the people. Shall you read? Colossians 1, 12, 13. Praise the Lord. Are you happy, man? This is what you are. Don't never ever think you are not worthy. You are worthy to receive everything. Because you are clean, you have been justified, and you have been sanctified. And you are the legal son of God or daughter of God. Amen. So Colossians 1:12. And giving joyful thanks to the Father. Why you have to give joyful thanks to the Father? Who has qualified you. Hallelujah. This Word of God is portraying you. What happened to you the minute you accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord? In every angle possible. Hallelujah. It says, giving joyful thanks to the Father who has qualified you to share in the inheritance in His holy people. Look at the tense. He has qualified you. Means, what is it? He's done it. Come on, I'm giving you, man, from the Bank of England, £1 million voucher. You are just sitting here like this. This is more than £1 million voucher. God is telling you. This is the Word of God. Look at this. This is a check can an experiment. But this Word of God never ever have experimented. And He's telling you. Every day morning, you look at this Word of God. Say, I am qualified to share inheritance of His holy people. Inheritance means you don't work hard. You don't even ask for it. It's already there. The minute you accepted Jesus as your Lord, this is what happened to you automatically. Religion will say, no, to get a qualification, you should work hard. You should, they come, and many Tamil churches, they preach, I am traveling from Egypt to the Canaan, place of Canaan. Oh Lord, are you with me? Are you coming with me? Are you in the night? Are you with me in the daytime? Like Moses and the Israelites, are you coming with me? There are so many songs. I am traveling through the desert. And are you with me? God, I feel your presence. God, never let the snakes to come and destroy me. Father, not David the Father, God. Too late, they never read what happened to spiritually there. Look. Who has qualified to share in the inheritance of His holy people. Because you are holy. Last week I said, you are holy. So that's why you are qualified to share the inheritance of holy people. Amen. People in the kingdom of light, you are in the light. Ah, so many things. If you meditate this, I am in the light, I am qualified, now I am sharing the inheritance of holy people. Do you think the visa is a problem? Do you think the house is a problem? Do you think anything is a problem? You are in. You are already qualified to share the inheritance of holy people. There's no limit for you, man. You are. First accept. First, you should know I am inherited. Then I will show you how to enjoy the inheritance. Okay. For he has rescued us from dominion of darkness. Ah. God is not going to deliver you anymore. God has already delivered you from the dominion of darkness. I'm telling you, if you know this truth, if anything pop up in your life or in your family, anything, you start saying to them, look, the God has already rescued me from the dominion of darkness. You have no business in my family. You have no business in my health. You have no business in my finance. Out in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That's like you are exercising your legal right. Hallelujah. Because the surrounding, this is a fallen world. Don't think if you sit like this, everything will happen nicely. You start believing the word of God and start proclaiming what is done to you, to this environment. Say, like today, weather. I thought that's it. I can't make it. But I made it much quicker than ever before. Nothing can stop you. No dark forces, no dominion will ever touch you because you have been already delivered. Already delivered. Look at the word. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us. You don't have to travel. God invented Uber, 2000 years before. He brought you into the kingdom of Son he loves. So where are you now? Come on, it's not $1 million question. Where are you now? You have been rescued and you have been brought over. You are not traveling. It's not an Israelite between Egypt and Canaan. You are not traveling. It will never applicable to you. You are already reached the better place than Canaan or better place than Eden because you are in the kingdom of the Son he loves. Woo! Hallelujah. Better than England, better than Australia, better than any place on the universe. Spiritually, you have reached. Because he brought you in. Are you happy, man?
Amen.
Your spirit is not wandering around in somewhere. You are already. The spirit is the real man. I don't give a big hands and applause. You don't see me, you know that. You don't see me. Even this, I said there's some person inside. That person is a real born again inner man. Bible says inner man. The status of the knowledge of this inner man is reflect in your life. I am indicating your inner man. Who is he really? He's already in the brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves. In whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. Why don't you give a big hand and applause? There's no dark forces can have a dominion over that. What a good news, man. I'm telling you, you will never ever have an accident. I'm telling you, you will never ever fall in sick. Because this word of God clearly saying is, he has broken the bondage of the dominion of darkness. He brought you in the kingdom of his Son he loves. Amen. Hallelujah. You have the redemptions and you have forgiveness of sins. Hallelujah. This is the reality, man. Okay, I happy. This is what really you are. Don't focus on physically or fleshly. That will destroy you. Bible says that the thoughts of flesh is a death, but the thoughts of spirit is giving you life. This is the reality. This is the true real things that you are no longer under the dominion of darkness. You already in the marvelous Son. He loves. Kingdom of marvelous Son. Kingdom of Jesus Christ. You are already in. Hallelujah. Don't pray anymore. Matthew says, oh, Heavenly Father, let the kingdom come. That's too late. I am already in the kingdom. Hallelujah. You agree? That's why I'm telling you, encourage you, read the epistle of Paul. We will tell you what has happened to you really. Okay? The latest report. John 8:36. John 8:36. So if Son sets you free, you will be free indeed. You don't need any explanation of this. If Jesus said, "I set you free," you are free indeed. Why don't you give a big hand? The whole universe is looking for, I need freedom. You see the march, you see the freedom cry and things like that. Just believe in Jesus Christ. You are free man. Nothing will bind you anymore. It can be a government or bad government, or it can be any system, or it can be any addiction, it can be anything, or mental depression. Nothing can bind you anymore. Because you are free indeed. Why don't you give a big answer? You are free indeed. You are free indeed. Because Son of God set you free. Hallelujah. Are you happy, man? Come on, let's smile, buddy. And quickly, the last, I have so many points about that. God's Spirit abides in you forever. John 14:26.
But the Comforter,
yeah,
and Counselor, Helper, Intercessor, and Advocator, Strengthener, stand by, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, in my place, to represent me and act on my behalf, he will teach you all things. And he will cause you to recall, will remind you of, bring to your remembrance everything I have told you.
Hallelujah. Look, I taught you last week, John 14:16-17, I will pray, the Holy Spirit will come and be with you and in you forever. Hallelujah. Say, Holy Spirit. According to Jesus Christ's prayer, Holy Spirit is dwelling in me forever. Say hi to Holy Spirit. Talk to him if he's dead. Faith will respond. Say hi. Say hi, Holy Spirit.
Hi.
Thank you for living in me. The world doesn't know. They think you are under the weather, but you know he's living in you. Hallelujah. And what type of person he is? Look, but the Comforter. Comforter means counselor. So you don't need any counseling. Hallelujah. Counselor, Helper. Helper is already there. So what happened to you? I'm teaching English. You have been helped. Say, I've been helped. Don't ask me, help me, help me. It's a, stop it. Say, I'm being helped. Tell the situation, I am being helped. The Helper is inside me. So shut up. Every situation you shut up and get lost. Because I am being helped. Say Amen. Why don't you give a big answer of applause? You have a Helper. The Helper, the mighty God, the power of God is inside you, man. The latest cars have an inbuilt GPS system. And I have many gadgets in my car, I don't know how to use. One day, I press home button. It says, we are alerting the emergency. We are transmitting your GPS position to the nearest rescue center. And, I said, I cancel it immediately. Because the car has an inbuilt helper. How much more? How much more? Hallelujah. You will never ever be helpless. You have been helped. Intercessor, he will pray for you. Someday you may sleep. He will pray for you. Hallelujah. Advocate, he's the best lawyer you could find. He will give you amazing ideas. Amazing ideas. Strengthener means you have been strengthened. Tell me, I'm not a weaker person. I've been strengthened. Because the strengthener is inside me. I'm telling you, the mighty God is inside you. And what he is inside for? To help you. To strengthen you. The Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, in my place to represent. When disciples had Jesus Christ in their midst, but same type of person is inside you. Hallelujah. That's why the disciples were, until Holy Spirit came to them, they couldn't do any miracles. They couldn't do any mighty works. Hallelujah. So you and me, when you're born again, I'm telling you those who are online, when in the minute you're born again, you have an inbuilt Holy Spirit is inside you. He's a helper, counselor, intercessor, advocate, strengthener, and standby. Standby means you can pray for somebody and you can be God. The Holy Spirit will be standby with that person. Why don't you give a big hand of applause? We have been traveling all over the world. Me and my past attendance, we pray for so many people, many people, names I have forgotten. But the standby, the Holy Spirit, the minute I pray for them, the minute pastor prayed for them, immediately he will be standby. That's all. What a comfortable thing, man. Hallelujah. Don't you feel happy? You know, sometimes I feel, oh, I pray for them, what will happen to them? Then I should keep remembering, I should pray. Yes, that's good. But you should know, the minute you mention a person, when the minute you pray for them, the God, the mighty God, the one who resurrected Jesus Christ from the dead, he is standby with them. So if you pray for any of your relatives, don't worry, man, anymore. You know, you're sure for that, the Holy Spirit is next to them. And the Holy Spirit will always remind you, look, the gospel of Jesus Christ. He will never come to condemn you. People teach wrongly. He will condemn the world about sin. So, I happy man, this functions, or this God, this type of God is dwelling inside you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every minute you think about that, I have been helped. I am not a weaker person. I am a mighty man. I am a mighty man. Because why? It's not, I go to gym or I have connection with the top level. No. The greater God is in me.
Amen.
That's what the Bible says. The greater one is dwelling in you than the ones in the world.
Amen.
This is the greater one. The Holy Spirit inside you. Hallelujah. So, last point. I will come back to some other time, but I'll tell you, you are fully packed, beautifully created, powered, and holy, like Jesus Christ, you are right now. You are right now. This is the reality. Don't be shy, don't listen to this stupid religious people preaching. But I'm telling you, out of grace of Jesus Christ, this all being given to you as a free gift. Hallelujah. That is, the Spirit will always give you joy. This is the reality. The reality is, I have the life of Christ in me. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. I am delivered. I've been washed. I've been sanctified. I've been justified. I have a peace with God, and I have a Holy Spirit, advocate, counselor, strengthener, helper, is inside me forever. Hallelujah, he's inside me forever. That's what Jesus said. The living water, living rivers is inside you. The river is the good thing. That is the Holy Spirit, he said. The Holy Spirit is a living river, not one river. The river is inside you. When the river comes, there's a life. The person can have no hope. There's no way to escape. It can be a desert. But when the living water comes, there's a life. Matter of time, it will be a life. Within a day, it will transform into a green pasture. Same way, when you preach this word of God, when you give the love of God to anyone and everyone, their life will be changed. They will be glorified. They will have a perfect, beautiful life. And you are the one. Every Christian is a carrying of living water. You give life to other people. Hallelujah. Shall we stand up and pray? Thank you. Dear Father, please pray with me. Dear Father, I thank you For your nature of righteousness in my spirit that produces your righteousness in all I do. Sin has no dominion over my life. Repeat again. Sin has no dominion over my life. I am conscious of my sinlessness just as Jesus was. My life is a manifestation of God's righteousness. Thank you, Lord, for I am unblameable in your sight. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You are blessed. You are blessed, man. You are blessed. You are living. You are a temple of a living God.
Amen.
You are extension of Jesus Christ on earth.
Amen.
Okay? Do and enjoy your life. Heal other people. When you help other people, that is the greatest satisfaction you can have. Hallelujah. You know, I've started nearly 1 year, but I'm tasting so many testimonies. I have a reason to live now. I have a reason to live. I have a reason to enjoy my life because I'm carrying the good news inside me. Wherever I go, I give this to everyone because this is a living rivers of water is coming out from me. Same into you. You are the fountain of righteousness inside you. Hallelujah. We close. Thank you, Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord. Thank you for this ministry. I bless this ministry. I command, multiply in the name of Jesus. Let this word of God, wherever it goes, it will bring forth deliverance, the happiness, the salvation. Whoever listens to this YouTube will be redeemed in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for the love of Heavenly Father, the grace of Jesus Christ, and the oneness of Holy Spirit. Be with us forever. Amen, amen, amen. You guys are blessed. God bless you. Amen.